Hi, I'm Thomas Telegdy. I work with DHI as Mike Plus Product Specialist. In November last year, we've released Mike Plus 2023. You may have seen one of the release webinars. Today, I want to talk about a new tool called Combine DEM Tiles, which sounds modest, but I'll show you three ways how to benefit from it. Elevation models are used in various situations in Mike Plus. If manholes or junctions have missing ground levels, you can use elevation data to fill those gaps. You may trace a riverbed as an initial step for a river model, or, very important for flood modeling, elevation data is necessary to create a 2D overland mesh. So, what's the problem or the challenge? When you download DEM data, it very often comes in a series of tiles. In other words, adjacent rectangular raster files, one beside or above the other. And in some cases, it's more convenient to have one big file instead of many small ones. And first of all, this is what the tool does. It combines adjacent tiles to one big file. While doing so, you may keep the cell size, or you can increase the cell size, and by doing so, you eliminate detail you don't need, or data noise. The third benefit of this tool is it reads GeoTIFF, Esri ASCII grid, and DFS2 files, and it also writes those formats independently from the input. And that's why it also acts as a converter between those file formats. This is an empty Mike Plus project. Under Tools, I find Combine DEM Tiles. I click. Here I insert any raster file. Here are the formats we support, and those are TIFF files. Let's open the southeast part. Here I define the output. I call it like the input. SEDFS2 and save and run. And I want to add it to the project. And here it is. At the bottom of the layers, classified according to the elevation. DFS is the native mic format. We have DFS 3, 2, 1, and 0, depending on the number of dimensions included in the file. And some functions in Mic Plus support only DFS format, so that's why it is so handy to have this conversion. But the conversion also works in the other directions, so to GeoTIFF and S3 ASCII grid, or between GeoTIFF and S3 ASCII grid. Now let's have a look at the core functionality, combine DEM tiles. Quickly closing those two, deleting this layer. First, I add a new folder. You'll see in a second why. I call it DEM. And now I right-click and add layers. It's a raster layer. It's again TIFF files. And it's all four files. This is just to show the files we want to combine. So here they are, four tiles. Now I want to create one big tile out of those. Combine the DEM tiles, insert, take all four. Now let's save this as a Esri ASCII grid called O4. Run. I add it again to the project. And close. And here you see the newly created ASCII grid file. Now, there is already one benefit of having one file only, the coloring. Because the original four files all have their own color scheme stretched between the highest and the lowest point. And that's, of course, much more difficult to read than this one. Of course, I could create a palette and apply the same palette to all four files, but the question is, what is faster? In the last part of the video, I want to show you resample. Also, let's see what happens if one tile is missing. I insert northeast, southeast, southwest, but I skip northwest. I want to create an ASCII file. I can also type the name directly into the field. This will be saved to the same directory as the MicPlus database. And as a resampling factor, I use 50, which means as the original data has a 1 meter resolution, the generated file will have a 50 meter resolution. Hit run and add the resulting file. Now for the tile which is missing, you see that it has been replaced by null or delete values. That's good. You also see the 50 meter cells, while they are quite coarse. It's interesting to note that the new file starts from the lower left corner. Here it's extended beyond the original data because the 50 meters don't match exactly the edges of the original file. But that's quite common for raster files to start in the lower left corner. Each cell value of the new file equals the average of the 2,500 original cells. At the edges, where we have some null values, the new value is based on the existing cells only. So the null values really influence the new file as expected. A closing remark, I like the icon, but it's a bit ironic that one function which is not covered is combine overlapping tiles. In case your tiles overlap, the tool will issue a warning and stop. But typically, tiles don't overlap anyway, so that's not a big issue. Hopefully, combine DEM tiles will help you working with elevation data more efficiently. Drop any questions you have in the comments below. Thanks for watching and see you next time.